Where I come from, it's called fairness, just simple fairness. The middle class is struggling. The middle class under John McCain's tax proposals, 100 million families, middle class families, households to be precise. They got not a single change. They got not a single break in taxes. No one making less than $250,000 under Barack Obama's plan will see one single penny of their tax raise, whether it's their capital gains tax, their income tax, investment tax, any tax. And 95% of the people in the United States of America making less than $150,000 will get a tax break. Now, that seems to me to be simple fairness. The economic engine of America is the middle class. It's the people listening to this broadcast. When you do well, America does well. Even the wealthy do well. This is not punitive. John wants to add $300 million, billion dollars in new tax cuts per year for corporate America and the very wealthy, while giving virtually nothing to the middle class. We have a different value set. The middle class is the economic engine. It's fair. They deserve the tax breaks, not the super wealthy who are doing pretty well. They don't need any more tax breaks. And by the way, they'll pay no more than they did under Ronald Reagan.
Governor?
I do take issue with some of the principle there, with that redistribution of wealth principle that seems to be espoused by you. But when you talk about Barack's plan to tax increase affecting only those making $250,000 a year or more, you're forgetting the millions of small businesses that are going to fit into that category. So they're going to be the ones paying higher taxes, thus resulting in fewer jobs being created and less productivity. Now, you said recently that higher taxes or asking for higher taxes or paying higher taxes is patriotic. In the middle class of America, which is where Todd and I have been, you know, all of our lives, that's not patriotic. Patriotic is saying, government, you know, you're not always the solution. In fact, too often you're the problem. So government, lessen the tax burden on the private sector and on our families and get out of the way and let the private sector and our families grow and thrive and prosper. An increased tax formula that Barack Obama is proposing, in addition to nearly $1 trillion in new spending that he's proposing, is the backwards way of trying to grow our economy.
Governor, are you interested in defending Senator McCain's health care plan?
I am, because he's got a good health care plan that is detailed, and I want to give you a couple of details on that. He's proposing a $5,000 tax credit for families so that they can get out there and they can purchase their own health care coverage. And that's a smart thing to do. That's budget neutral. That doesn't cost the government anything, as opposed to Barack Obama's plan to mandate health care coverage and have this universal government-run program. And unless you're pleased with the way that the federal government has been running anything lately, I don't think that it's going to be real pleasing for Americans to consider health care being taken over by the feds. But a $5,000 health care credit through our income tax, that's budget neutral, that's going to help. And he also wants to erase those artificial lines between states so that through competition, we can cross state lines. And if there's a better plan offered somewhere else, we'd be able to purchase that. All so right. Affordability and accessibility will be the keys there with that $5,000 tax credit also being offered.
Thank you, Governor. Senator.
Gwen, I don't know where to start. We don't call it redistribution in my neighborhood, Scranton, Claymont, Wilmington, the places I grew up, to give the fair to say that not giving ExxonMobil another $4 billion tax cut this year, as John calls for, and giving it to middle-class people to be able to pay to get their kids to college. We don't call that redistribution. We call that fairness, number one. Number two, factually, 95% of the small businesses in America, their owners make less than $250,000 a year. They would not get one single solitary penny increase in taxes, those small businesses. Now, with regard to the health care plan, you know, it's with one hand you give it, the other you take it. You know how John McCain pays for his $5,000 tax credit you're going to get, a family will get? He taxes as income every one of you out there, every one of you listening who has a health care plan through your employer. That's how he raises $3.6 trillion on your taxing your health care benefit to give you a $5,000 plan, which his website points out will go straight to the insurance company. And then you're going to have to replace a $12,000, that's the average cost of the plan you get through your employer. It costs $12,000. You're going to have to pay replace a $12,000 plan because 20 million of you are going to be dropped. 20 million of you will be dropped. So you're going to have to replace a $12,000 plan with a $5,000 check you've just given to the insurance company. I call that the ultimate bridge to nowhere.